acting has been my dream all my life, but I have zero experiences. Where do I even start? Well, this step-by-step series is made for you. Today, I will be introducing you the basic structure of the acting industry and everything you need to know in the beginning before getting an agent. Welcome back, this is Joe. If this is your first time here, welcome. I'm a Chinese actress living in Hollywood North, chasing the big dream of getting that Golden Man Oscar. But ever since I started my YouTube channel, many of you have reached out to me asking and how you can start your own career. And to be honest, it's a little bit more complicated than it seems. Well, here I am spilling the beans from all the acting schools I've been to, from my own personal experience, and letting you know everything you need to every step of the way. This is a multi-part series and telling you how to start your acting career from each step of the way, so everything will be broken down step by step in detail for you to consider and take. The very step for you when you're starting is to understand the basic structure of the Hollywood acting industry. To put it simply, it's a pyramid-like hierarchy operating system. To break it down, when a network studio company such as Warner Bros. Have a script that they would like to film, they hire a production team consisting of directors, producers, writers, and crew to create it. The production team contacts the casting company with roles they specifically want in this project, and the casting company are responsible for finding the best actors suitable for these roles. They do so by announcing casting notices for auditions to which agencies sees and submit their actors to. Now, each level acts like its own filter, and based on this standard, there is no bypassing from one level to the other. Now, that means if you want to start auditioning, you need agency representation. On very rare occasions, casting companies do open call casting notices, and they would post that on a public forum such as Facebook, allowing everyone from all experiences with or without representation to submit themselves and go on an audition. But that is very, very, very uncommon. Now, however, if it's for a smaller independent production such as a student film or with independent filmmakers, you can submit to the audition directly without an agent. These casting notices are usually posted on a public platform as well, such as Facebook or other casting platforms that allows you to submit your material without an agent. So although you won't be getting big roles in a big TV show or in movies, but these are perfect starting point when you want to accumulate experiences or just let your creative side shine while you're in your journey of trying to get an agent. Now, with that said, here is a basic step-by-step process from beginning to getting an agent. The first step is to go to an acting school and learn how to act in front of a camera. Then you need to create a submission package, which consists of headshots, demo reels, your resume, and your cover letter that you will be using to get an agent. Now, as a bonus to add to your experiences during your time in finding an agent, work on independent productions and just try out acting with other people. And eventually get an agency representation who will start submitting you to all kinds of auditions. Here are the common questions that I get.
So, can I try to contact casting directors and productions about opportunities?
No. That's a big no-no. Unless the casting notice states that it is open for everybody to directly contact them, or else it's a no. The system is set up in a way to filter out inexperienced and incompatible actors, and most productions rely on this system for casting. However, if you are in a networking opportunity like workshops or showcase performance where casting directors, agents, and sometimes even producers are invited, go ahead, talk to them, let your inner extrovert out. Most likely, most of them are there in order to look for new faces for hiring. Now, what about the stories of actors getting approached on the street by a big agent and getting big immediately? Well, those are anecdotal cases. They are not common. It does not happen to 99% of us, including me. So no, don't rely on that. Please don't walk around Walmart glammed up all the time in hopes that an agent would see you and suddenly sign you, because there is actually a lot of them that are scams as well. And these are the cases where the media would really glamorize it and make it seem like it's going to happen to any of us. No. Most actors, even who are A-listers now, Start by grinding from the ground up, serving in restaurants and bars and sleeping on somebody's couch until something actually happens. How long does it take for you to become an actor working full time? On average, probably more than 4 or 5 years. I mean, less if you're living in an area where there's a lot of production, such as LA, and if you have a really good look where you can play a lot of common characters in a lot of different types of shows, and even less time if you already are familiar with the language and have the appropriate accent that is required, and of course if you know how to act and is extroverted enough to know how to network with people and make friends and just be a great person to work with on set all the time, and can fully commit yourself to the grind and non-stop, all of that together, plus a lot of luck, it'll be less. For me, as an example, I was in the modeling industry for about 2 to 3 years before I finally slipped in to film and TV productions. Then it was another year to a year and a half before I booked my very first TV show. Yeah. Just understand that there is a lot of work for you to do even to just get to that starting gate in the industry standard. It is a grind, a marathon. It is not like a, okay, I'm ready to go. Did you get super rich once you are on a TV show or a film? No. You don't get super rich. I mean, if we're talking about 99% of actors' journey, no. I mean, even if you won some independent film festival for your brilliant acting work, a full-time bartender or server might actually make more money than you. Just go watch my video about how much actors actually make. Now, of course, if you do so happen to be one of those special case, on a very uncommon ground, where the very first role that you got booked on a TV or a film is a huge production, like a main role on a Marvel movie, then sure, you get rich right away. If you want to know the top things I wished I knew before I decided to pursue acting, I'm gonna link the video on the description down below. If even after you understand the basic structure of the acting industry and you still want to pursue your dream in acting, then come back to next week's video where I'm going to take you through the first step and breaking down detail for you on how to find the perfect acting school and acting coach for you. And that's the video for today. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. If you like this video and you want to follow my journey and getting that Oscar, riding through the representation wave as an Asian actor, then press like, subscribe, and the bell button. I post videos on Fridays and I'll see you next time. Bye.
So Josie, what are you going to do for work after you graduate?
I want to be an actor. And then they proceeded to give me their very disappointed opinions.